Hi everyone, welcome to Python learning series for network engineers. This is the second video on how to initiate SSH connection from jump host using Python. In the first video we have seen overview of this script, how to initiate it. So you can see here, using a Linux machine, I am using Linux machine as jump host and first initiating SSH to that, and from there I am executing command on another Cisco device. You can see the logged in IP is 0.18, so this is the jump host IP. Now let's start writing it. Here I have a Python file called jump host demo. Here we'll start writing this script. First, what we'll do here, I already have the variables defined to save the time. So first we'll import the library from netmiko import. First we'll import netmiko, and here we'll initiate a connection. We'll call that as netconnect equals netmiko, and for netmiko we'll see what are the parameters we need to give. So we'll be using Linux client first, so we need to give device type as Linux. You can see here parameter device type, so let us give that. Device type is Linux underscore SSH, and then host we have already defined here, so we can give that host IP. Then username, jump host user, and for password, Linux jump host password. If you want to verify that, you can see it here, the value is what we need to pass. After that, what we can do here, let's try printing the prompt. Print the same connection, netconnect dot find prompt. First let us try printing it. You can see the prompt, it is user 1 at Ubuntu OS 2. That is the prompt of this jump machine. We can just give a message here, print connecting to the jump host. Now after connection is established, we'll just give a print. Connected to the jump host. The message formatting later we will do. This is for just for the reference. Now after connecting to the jump host, we need to initiate SSH to the destination device. So we'll just give another print statement here. In the new line, one more additional line there, connecting to the destination device. Then we need to execute the command. So let's verify what is find prompt, and we'll see what is write channel in netmiko. So let's go to the documentation. So you can see here is a method called write channel. This is a generic method for executing any command in the terminal. If you just give write channel, it is same like paramigo, it will just go and execute the command. And let's search what is find prompt. So it finds the current device prompt, which we have already done here. So let's do a write channel netconnect dot write channel, and here for Linux for initiating SSH connection, the command is SSH space the router username we need to give. Router user, after that we need to give one @ and then router IP. Let's give a /n there. Here we can give a delay if there is a delay for getting the password prompt, so for that we are giving a delay. For adding delay, you need to import time. Then the output, whatever we are getting, we'll just try printing it here. Output equals netconnect dot. So whatever we are written, after that we'll just try reading the channel, or we'll try finding the prompt. Let's try printing the output. Now you can see the message connecting to the jump host. Okay, connected to the jump host. So you can see here it is still finding the prompt. So instead of find prompt, let's try giving read channel. So you can see here, still it is not able to find the password prompt. Because this IP is not a valid IP, so we need to change this IP. Now let's try running it. Because I don't have any device in that IP. Now you can see I'm getting password prompt. So we can write up if condition here. If the string whatever we received, password in this output, for just confirmation, what we'll do, we'll just print a statement saying that received password prompt. Because in case of Cisco, when I was using Cisco as a gem host, there was a delay in getting this password prompt. I have to add minimum 10 seconds of delay here. So it took some time for me to figure out that. So it is better to add this message so that you can confirm you are receiving password within the time, within the defined time limit. And after that, again we will use the write channel method, netconnect dot write channel, then here we need to give the password. So I'll use fstring here. Router password and then a slash n. Here I'll add a delay. Delay of 2 seconds. Then here again we'll try finding the prompt. Then let's try printing the prompt. Netconnect dot find prompt, and above that I'll just print a statement slash n, then destination device prompt, and then I'll try printing this. Let's try running it. So you can see here now I'm receiving the 50s prompt, CSR 50s prompt. Here we will use a redispatch method and change the device type. So for that, first we'll define some commands. We'll call this as cmds and I'll give some commands here. Show IP interface brief, show IP route, then give show users also. Then we need to iterate through all these commands. So before iterating through each command, we'll do a redispatch. So for using redispatch, we need to import that as well here. So here you can see we need to define device type. Netconnect, comma, device type equals, it is Cisco underscore iOS. Now we need to iterate through each command. Then for cmd in cmds, then let's print a statement. Fstring, then slash n, executing the command, then we'll give cmd here. Then netconnect dot send command method we'll use. Then we need to pass the cmd. So we'll call that as router output, and let us try printing that output. So you can see here the complete script. First, I'm connecting to Linux, the jump host using netmiko, and from there I'm initiating SSH to Cisco, and there I'm using redispatch method and executing these commands. So now it is connected to the jump machine and it received password prompt. You can see it is executing the commands. Show IP interface brief. Yeah, you can see the show users details. It is connecting from 0.18. In the next video, we'll see how to handle the exceptions like jump host not reachable, or authentication failed, or the destination device not reachable cases. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.